We're talking to Cody No Love. Cody underscore No Love, right?
Cody underscore No Love, yeah.
Instagram, make sure to follow him and Twitter as well. So right now, who are the top three pound-for-pound fighters in MMA?
Top three?
Yeah.
You got to go with Daniel Cormier, Khabib. When I say his last name, you know, Khabib. And I don't know, it's a toss-up, you know. Third, I got to think that you have to throw, man, top three.
Do you put Nate in there or Nick, even though they haven't fought, they're still.
But that, I thought you put Frankie Edgar in there. You know, he's a guy that's consistent throughout his 14-year career. You know, he's always been at the top, fighting the top guys, even out of his weight class, in his weight class. So Frankie can be up there. I think it's a toss-up, man. I think that you go one and two is kind of evident. You know, Demetrius Johnson, he's up there as well. You know, he just had a little slip-up, but he consecutively defended his title 11 times.
Fedor came back strong.
Yeah, Fedor looked good, man. Fedor looked good doing his thing in Bellator. Man, they're just so, I think it just, that's something that changes all the time, the top three. You know, it's hard. You crack the top five in the world being the best. You know, that's just, you know, an honor in itself. Anywhere up there, any of those guys could be.
Now, Cody, people watching, they see you walk in a cage, and they think everything was easy. They don't realize that it's 24/7, 365. What's your day like routine when you're not in camp, just to stay in shape so you don't balloon up, so you don't?
I mean, like I said, you see me. I walk around, you know, 147, 150. I stay in shape. I stay ready.
You have to be very disciplined for that.
Very disciplined. You know, I got an amazing wife. She, cooks breakfast, lunch, dinner. She's my best friend, so she takes care of me with the meals, my nutrition, make sure I'm staying, you know, healthy. I'm that aspect.
She trains too, right?
Yeah, she trains. Yeah, she's got Thailand blood in her. She's half Thai, so she does the Muay Thai, and you know, it's good to have her in the gym. Just, you know, she comes to the gym watching me train, fight camp. Super supportive.
When Russell Peters is around, it's always,
it's
like
always
a big
loud.
Party.
Yeah, it's a party. Man. He brings a party.
Russell, I thought you were going to choke him out or something.
Who? Yeah, no, these aren't the guys you're going to try and choke out.
No?
Well, you want to choke out people that don't know how to be choked out.
So, let me ask you this.
You can't try and choke out guys that have choked out of the fence.
Yeah. They know how to choke out.
You look squirrel at the ears and you go, you don't choke that guy out.
You can't.
Cody walks around at his weight. What do you think about that? I think
Cody Garbrandt's full of shit. He's 180 pounds right now.
He's not 180.
It's all penis. It's incredible.
It's true. I gotta cut some weight, like you said. Yeah. So I lose it.
It shows a lot of discipline. It's very hard.
I add one of my own.
So right now, who do you want to see him fight next?
Let's see.
Look at that shirt. Stockton Slot.
who do I want to see Cody fight? Who do you think you want to fight? John Dodson?
I'll fight whoever, you know. I think that Rafael Sensal, you got, you know, Dominic Cruz coming back. You know,
well, yeah, it'd be a good rematch for you and Dominic.
Dominic, you know, obviously, you know, TJ would be a nice...
he's not going
to
do it yet.
Get that one back. Yeah, exactly. But those are the fights. So anyone that gets me back to TJ, and hopefully TJ stays a champion, stays up there, I'd like to get...
Who's TJ? Who's his mandatory now?
Oh, I don't know.
He was calling out Tank.
Tank.
He was calling out Gervonta Davis.
Fucked up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's them. Tank would destroy that pool.
It's true.
It's true. I like when like they don't understand. It's a different sport. Yeah. Your breathing is different. I mean, you used to box, so you know.
Yeah, it's a different boxing. TJ's not a good just straight boxer, you know what I mean?
No.
He's not, you know.
That doesn't make him a good gay boxer, but right. Whether it's, you know, sexuality is irrelevant when it comes to boxing.
Most MMA fighters can't box, though. Not like you and brothers. They actually don't.
I think that's why, you know, having that amateur experience and, you know, go to the pro level, but I had a little, you know, lengthy amateur experience that, you know, dozens of fight. That's what catapulted me a step above the MMA striking game. And, you know, it was my first passion. I really, you know, crafted my skills in the boxing. It took me to be a world champion in MMA, and under, you know, 5 years, I was professional.
You know, it's crazy. You saw the McGregor-Khabib fight. You saw the McGregor-Khabib fight. But actually, Chuck Zito was there. But nobody messed with him. Everybody was fighting left and right. Why do you think no one tried to mess with
him? Because Chuck had two chairs in his hands.
Yeah, two chairs.
I was afraid to lose him.
And I took him home.
Yeah. So you got Chuck Zito walking out with two chairs. My fight's gone. What do you think's happened? Chuck Zito's carrying two chairs. He's going to bash someone in the face with these. You know, no one's
It's not the first time he hit somebody with a chair,
that's
I would imagine.
Exactly. Probably not the last.
Now, Chuck, I saw your house was like a boxing museum. Is that your house?
What I My saw? House, yeah, yeah. I got a lot
of
memorabilia.
You got more shit than the Hall of Fame.
I got a lot, absolutely. I got a lot of memorabilia in my house. All kinds of things.
I love the Gotti. I love the Gotti.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, man.
Toro. I have his championship belt. Yep. His WBC belt.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's Toro's, crazy. Yeah.
His wife killed him, right?
Yeah.
That's curious. You heard about
yeah.
that, right?
Yeah, I heard about it. Yeah, I remember it clearly.
Yeah. She got charged in 2 weeks. They got arrested. 2 weeks later, they let her out saying he hung himself.
Yeah. There's no way.
With a purse strap.
Yeah.
That was this big.
It's sad. People loved him.
Oh, yeah,
he was great.
Did
was
you know
great.
Him?
He was an awesome,
I met him, but I didn't
awesome
know
awesome guy.
I knew him from the amateurs. A guy from my gym back home fought him a few times as an amateur and beat him. But that doesn't mean that guy went on to do great things.
He was the original blood and guts warrior.
Okay, last question. Who's the best pound-for-pound boxer in the world? Boxer.
Ellie Sekman. Now? He's amazing.
Now?
Is it Mikey? Is it Lomachenko? Is it Mayweather still? Is it Canelo?
I believe it's Lomachenko. Yeah. Lomachenko's a badass dude, man. And every guy he fights, they quit on a stool. The last three guys quit on their stool.
Yeah, he's amazing.
Last four guys.
That's four guys.
And then last one he knocked out in a body shot.
Four guys quit on their stool. Is this guy bad or what?
He stopped.
He's about Linares with the body shot.
Yeah.
Linares is tough, too.
Yeah. And you know what's funny? I talked to him last night. He told me he won that fight with a hand and a half because his shoulder was so messed up, he couldn't use his hand.
Who, Lomachenko? Nice.
Yeah, he's badass.
Yeah, I'm not a huge Linares fan.
Literally the best way to ever
All right, Chuck Zito. People follow you at Chuck Zito, Cody_NoLove, and at Russell Peters. Stay tuned. Please, you can find that
comment.
Reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter. At Segback. Follow me on Twitter.
And I mean, that's the way you want. Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rockin' with the best, Ellie Sekback. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you watching, ES News. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the crime, competition, he abusing them. No use in trying it, if you the competitor, you should just pray.